Amos, as usual, what a wonderful lecture for this clarifying message that you have conveyed to us. And I would like to agree with what Amos said, that we definitely should give a medal to Amos and his team for being so relaxed and outstanding, despite all the pressures in organizing such a conference. And also Amos's entrance into this new position, this really is working out well. In a few minutes, I have been told that I will be introducing Tal Shalev, who will be interviewing Minister Kahlon. But Minister Kahlon has yet to arrive. I have been told that he is 3 or 4 minutes away. I believe that's true. And in the meantime, I cannot but tell you the following thing. That the IDC Herzliya has some 7,500 students. And of these 7,500 students, 2,000 are studying at the international school. And we teach them social sciences. And I also wanted to tell you that a high percentage of our students here at the IDC Herzliya are officers, female and male officers from combat units. I would also like to tell you that in the event that anyone was an officer in a combat unit, they are exempt from a psychometric exam here at the university and are admitted solely upon their matriculation exams. It is part of the Zionism that has been brought into this establishment by Professor Uriel Reichman. I would also like to tell you that each student here at the IDC Herzliya that serves 12 days or more in reserves gets 2 credit points as an elective course. And in addition, when they return from reserve duty, there are special exams, special dates that they can take their exams on. And now I have been told that there is a change, a small change in our program. You are saying there is a change, the president says there is no change, and therefore, since he is my employer and you're not, and maybe I also want to have a raise, so I have to listen to the president. Is Minister Kahlon here in the radius of the IDC Herzliya? Within 5 minutes, he will be here. Okay, Rafi, how long is your presentation? 1 hour. Okay, so I would suggest that we wait for Minister Kahlon, and I'll tell you why. I am saying that for democratic reasons, since we are the only democracy in the Middle East, and since the president told me that we are waiting for Kahlon, and therefore we will wait for Kahlon. I would also like to continue and say a few more things about the IDC. Among our students who come from overseas, about 30% of our overseas students come from the United States, which means about 550 students. Here on campus, we have 250 students from France who have come here. We have 80 students from South Africa. The other third of the students come from Europe, so we have a third Europeans, a third from North America, and a third from Asia, Africa, and Israel at the international school. And I also wanted to tell you that 70% of these students actually come to Israel as olim, as new immigrants. And I want to tell you something that's fascinating. 150 of the students that we have embraced here at the IDC are graduates of a program called Gar'in Tzabar, which is students who are lone soldiers who come to Israel, and 150 of these lone soldiers study here at the IDC. This entire thing means that per square meter, I would define the IDC Herzliya as the most Zionist academic place in Israel per square meter. Another thing that might be of interest to you is that the Council of Higher Education has carried out a poll where, of 67 universities and colleges, where do the international students study for full degrees? And 40% of all students in Israel who study for full degrees in English study here at the IDC, even though the IDC, compared to the student body in Israel, comprises only 1.25%. So we are 40 times as international as other places. And I'm very happy to see that Ambassador Ron Prosor has arrived. Please stand up. Please stand up, sir. Ron Prosor. Just like we take the best players, such as Amos Gilad, in our opening five, we also got on board Ron Prosor, who has also contributed to the State of Israel by currently being in the Abba Ibn chair. We have a good trainer. We have Professor Eichmann. So he has been building this basketball team very seriously, and we are one of the only basketball teams in Israel that actually wins. So that's nice. I would also like to tell you that if you don't know, then in our international school, which is taught in English, we teach business and economics, communication, psychology. We also teach computer science, and we also teach diplomacy, strategy, and government. And while the conference is taking place here, you can see groups and hear experiences of everything that we teach here at the IDC. And if you happen to have Israeli children who would like to take the Hebrew courses and tracks, then you are welcome to have them registered. You can also register for the English track, even though there's quite a lot of pressure here in registration, and we'll be going into wait lists soon. But anyone who is taking part in this conference, please use this opportunity to speak to the various deans who are here in the room. Speak to me, if you like, about the international school, and we will help you register. Yes, someone is holding their hand up. Yes, sir. I'm sorry, I cannot interpret anyone speaking from the audience without a microphone. I understand. I am very happy. I have an instruction from my president, and unfortunately I have to respect his request. And I also request Minister Kahlon, and I am waiting for him patiently. And in the meantime, I will tell you a few things in order to just use this time. And the important thing is that we are meeting the schedule, because all the speakers except me have spoken so succinctly and briefly. So I am respecting your request, and I would like to respect you and honor you. And unfortunately, I will have to take the order from my president, and we will wait patiently for Minister Kahlon. Is that okay? Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. It is part of the democracy here at the IDC. The president decides and we perform. That's why we have been so successful until now, because of this democracy we have here. I would also like to tell you that Minister Kahlon, is there any intelligence on Minister Kahlon that anyone would like to share with me? No. No, there is no news to date. I wanted to tell you one more thing, but you have made me lose my train of thought. What a shame. It was something interesting. But I'm 68, so I don't remember things all that well anymore. Are there any more questions or comments from the audience? Something about positive psychological effects, so that we can remain positive? Because the best thing is to be diplomatic, to be polite and positive, even though we're the only democracy in the Middle East. Yes, please. Why do we not teach in French? That is an excellent question. Because there is no critical mass sufficient for studies in French. There is a demand here by 2,000 students who want to study in English. Some come from China, some come from Singapore, some come from Australia, some come from Mongolia, some come from Nepal, and others come from Kazakhstan. Some come from Kyrgyzstan, and others come from Jordan. But all of them want to study in English, because English, I suppose, is the language that is more unifying. I understand. And yet, even though so many people speak French, if you've noticed, in the European Union, they speak English and not French. And not even in German. They don't even speak Spanish or Portuguese. They speak English. And if there had been demand, huge demand, if you had brought 2,000 new immigrants from France here to the IDC, all of whom would want to study here, maybe we would have entered into French as well. We also did another calculation, which is a tough one, and it's a very good question from you, but we're not sure we have enough academics in terms of critical mass that would be able to fill the ranks and teach everything required in French. Excuse me? You can give me a list. I would be so happy to meet with you later on. Give me names of 50 professors who can study here, who could teach here in French and all the different subjects. And if you can also bring me 2,000 students who want to learn in French and also a donor from France, and then we can actually build a maison française here together with all the French culture, and we will have such fun together, and we can also have wine together each afternoon right here under the eucalyptus trees. Yes, please. כמה עולה ללמוד פה? טוב, עכשיו אתה מדבר, כי יש לנו סגן נשיא פה לענייני כספים. אז אם תגיע, מדובר ב-12,500 דולר דמי לימוד, ועוד 2,500 דולר לחודש לדירות, אז משהו כמו 25,000 דולר, שזה הרבה פחות מבארצות הברית, זה בערך כמו בבריטניה, אבל באירופה יש כמה מדינות שבהן לא משלמים כלל שכר לימוד. יש מישהו מבין המשפחה שלך שהיה רוצה לבוא ללמוד כאן? הבנים שלך בני כמה? 4 שנה. טוב, היו כמה חבר'ה שעוד יהיו פה. רייכמן ואני אולי נשב על ספסל בגן ציבורי בנתניה ונכתוב על את הזיכרונות שלנו. על טיולנו בעולם ועל כל הפאבים שבהם אנחנו יושבים ועל כל הבירה ששתינו.
והילדים יהיו כאן עם הדור הצעיר אשר יהיה גם כן אצלנו בבינתחומי, כמו שנאמר, בחיל להעביר את המנגינה הזאת. אי אפשר להפסיק. אז נמשיך. אם יש לכם שאלות או הערות, פסיכולוגיה חיובית, משהו, אפילו לא מאלה במכללה המערבית שם, אני רואה שאתם צוחקים. אולי אתם רוצים לומר לנו, דונה? יוצא מן הכלל. אני עדיין לא יודע מה הולך להתרחש מחבריי. מיקי, נו, מיקי, יש לך קצת מודיעין בשבילי? אני כנראה האחרון שידע, אין בעיה.
ולטרון.
אתם רוצים לדבר על מלחמת העצמאות ועל השפעתה עלינו? לטרון? הם נלחמים ברגלים נגד ירדן? אנחנו במלחמת העצמאות? עוד נחכה כמה דקות. אני רוצה להזכיר דרך אגב שבבינתחומי יש לנו 50 תלמידים אתיופים. רוב התלמידים האלה היו קצינים בצהל, רובם לוחמים, וכל אחד מהם מקבל מלגה מלאה כאן וכן מענק חודשי. יש לנו 120 בוגרים ביניהם, והם עובדים ב מקומות שהם אצל רואי חשבון בכירים ועורכי דין בכירים, והשגריר שלנו בפרו הוא אחד הבוגרים שלנו, ורבים מביניהם משמשים כשליחים בארצות הברית במכללות שונות, ונראה לי שזה ממש חשוב שכציוני אשר מאמין בציונות זו של הרצל וז'בוטינסקי ושל בן גוריון ושל מנחם בגין. אמרתי מנחם בגין, והם לא רוצים שאני אמשיך בהכרה, אנחנו נשאר בציונות הזאת עד כאן. אז בתוך דקה השר כחלון יגיע, אני אקרא מעט מילים ודברים על כחלון, בעיקר למען אלה מעבר לים שאינם מכירים את הרקע שלו. שר האוצר שלנו כחלון, אני רוצה לציין שהוא היה יושב ראש של ועדת הכלכלה של הכנסת, כמו כן חוקק יחד, יחדה בית כל החקיקה לגבי הבנקים, וזאת כאשר שימש שר התקשורת, הוא עשה מהפכה בעולם הסלולרי, ועד עצם היום הזה אנחנו מדברים, משלמים הרבה פחות מששילמנו על הטלפון הנייד. הוא זכה בפרס אביר איכות השלטון. אביר איכות השלטון. פרופסור אלכס מינץ אמר את הדברים נכונה, כל שש שעות יש לה עבודת מחקר, אז זה לא משנה, את הממשל הוא גמר לאחרונה, הוא למעשה חוקר מספר אחת. ושוב, אנחנו לא שומעים את הדברים מן האולם, כמה נקודות את נותנת לי על הצעתי. לא שומעים את התשובה, אני מצטערת. דיברת אנגלית, אנא עברית אליעזר בן יהודה הוא זה שזאת ארצו. ודרך אגב, הוא מנסה להכניס מהפכה גם בתחום הדיור ובאתגרים העומדים בפני העם פה. אתן לכם מעד רקע על השר כחלון. הוא נמצא כאן, יופי. הוא הגיע, נפלא. אתה תהיה מרוצה לכן, יופי. בבקשה, עם מלוא הכבוד.
את השר כחלון לבמה.
Let us invite Minister Kahlon, the Minister of Finance of the State of Israel, and Mrs. Tal Shalev, who will interview the minister, and I would like to thank you all for bearing with me with patience. Just according to our timetable, yes, we, in fact, we were early. Things were going faster than we thought. So I would like to thank you once again for your patience. And now I would like to invite Mrs. Tal Shalev, the political correspondent of Walla News Digital Network,